गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. इन कंटिन्यूशन वी सी द वन मोर इम्पोर्टेंट कोलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टी दैट इज ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर. कोलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टीज आर फोर. व्हाट आर दोस? रिलेटिव लोअरिंग ऑफ वेपर प्रेशर दैट कैन बी एक्सप्लेन बाय यूजिंग रॉल्ड प्रिंसिपल. सेकंड वन एलिवेशन इन बॉइलिंग पॉइंट एंड डिप्रेशन इन फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट. आफ्टर दैट फोर्थ कोलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टी ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर. This also one of the important colligative property. The osmotic pressure also depends on the number of particles of solute. We'll see here. Before seeing the osmotic pressure, what is the osmosis? We'll see what is the diffusion. What is the meaning of diffusion? Okay, the moving of gas or liquid particles from one end to other end we call as diffusion. For example, if you burn any agarbatti like that, what you get? You will get the some smell. For example, if you keep that agarbatti here, you will get the smell that end. Here into that end, that smell, odor. Will move from this end to that end. This we call as diffusion. And what is the meaning of osmosis? The movement of low concentrated particles into high concentrated particles into high concentrated solution or particles. Through a semi-permeable membrane, we call as osmosis. We'll see what is the meaning of semi-permeable membrane. What is that? What is the osmosis? The movement of solvent particles into solution through a semi-permeable membrane called as osmosis, or the movement of solvent particles from low concentrated area to high concentrated area through semi-permeable membrane we call as osmosis. What is the semi-permeable membrane? After that we see the experiment, osmosis experiment by using different instrument. What is the semi-permeable membrane? The membrane of the layer which allows the flow of solvent. We call as semi-permeable membrane. Example for semi-permeable membranes: parchment membrane, egg protein layer, potassium ferrocyanide. Okay, this is the synthetic or artificial semi-permeable membrane. Okay, here parchment membrane, egg protein layer. Okay, what we call bladder, animal air bladder. Okay, all these are acts as semi-permeable membranes. These two are artificial semi-permeable membranes. These three are natural semi-permeable membrane. What is the semi-permeable membrane? Okay, the membrane or layer or paper which allows the flow of solvent molecules. We call as semi-permeable membrane. Okay, this is about the osmosis and this is about the semi-permeable membrane and diffusion. See our experiment about the osmosis. तो हियर आई एम टेकिंग वन बीकर एंड हियर आई पुट द वन फनल इन ऑपोजिट वे इन ऑपोजिट वे दिस इज द फनल दिस फनल क्लोज विद द This funnel closed with the semi-permeating membrane. Semi-permeating membrane. Okay, here I am taking solution. Okay, here I am taking solvent in this beaker. This is the solvent. Okay, what means pure water? Pure water. This is the solution. Solution means here sugar plus water. Okay, here. Here, semi-permeable membrane. This is funnel. Funnel. Okay, this is the experiment one. Before osmosis. Okay, after 10 minutes or after 15 minutes, what happened here? These solvent particles. That means solvent particles means low concentrated area moves through semi-permeable membrane into solution. Okay, then the level of this funnel here level is there here. The level of here solution particles increases. That represents migration of solvent particles through semi-permeable membrane into solution. See, here I am drawing is just second experiment after osmosis. Here I am taking water. Water means pure water, pure solvent. See here, the solvent, pure water, same key, one funnel, with the opposite direction, this is semi-permeable membrane. Semi-permeable membrane. Okay, this is funnel. Okay, up to this level, we took solution now. Okay, this is the solution. Sugar plus water. Okay, this is solvent. After 10 minutes or 15 minutes, 10 to 30 minutes, after 10 to 30 minutes, 10 to 30 minutes, what happens here? The level of solution increases. This much increases. See, this level increases. This level increases. Why it increases? Just the movement of solvent particles through a semi-permeable membrane into solution. Okay, which is called, this is called osmosis. This is called osmosis. Okay, best example, flowers. Okay, if we cut the flower from the plant, that will be dull. If you spray water, what happens? That will glow. That means after the spraying water, it absorbs the water. That through that membrane, then it will close. That is also one of the process. That is also one of the process is called osmosis. If you keep egg, if you keep egg into normal water, it allows the water. It allows the water. Then it sells. For example, if you keep egg, boiled egg, into sodium chloride water. Water comes from boiled egg to outside. Concentration of sodium chloride is more now. Then we observe shrink. See here those two experiments. Here I want to explain this. You take egg. This is egg in water. Egg sodium chloride water. Here concentration of solvent particles moves from outside to inside. Then it swells. If you add sodium chloride, what happens? Concentration here more. The solvent particles moves from egg to sodium chloride. Then it becomes shrink. This we call hypertonic solutions. This we call hypertonic solutions. Hypertonic and hypertonic solutions. Just this is about the concept of the osmosis. What is the meaning of osmotic pressure? What is the definition of osmotic pressure? Osmotic pressure indicated with pi. Osmotic pressure indicated with pi. Here, see, what is the osmotic pressure? Here, for the migration of, you see here, the pressure which is applied. The pressure which is applied for the prevent of migration of the solvent particles into solution is called osmotic pressure. Or simply way, the pressure which is applied on solution for the prevent of osmosis. For the prevent of osmosis process, we call as osmotic pressure. Here, what happened? Solvent particles move now. You stop the movement of solvent particles by applying the pressure. That we call as osmotic pressure. That osmotic pressure indicated with pi. Osmotic pressure indicated with the osmotic pressure, the complete osmotic pressure of the solution, explained by using one equation, Van 't Hoff's dilute solution equation. Van 't Hoff equation or Van 't Hoff dilute solution equation. And if two solutions are having same concentration, has same osmotic pressure. If two solutions are there, 0.1 mm x, 0.1 mm y, both are having same concentration. Here both are having same osmotic pressure. Such solutions are called isotonic solutions. Isotonic solutions. Such solutions are simply considered as a isotonic solution. The osmotic pressure of any solution calculated by using Van der Helmholtz solution equation. We'll see in continuation what is the Van der Helmholtz solution equation. Okay, how we'll derive that Van der Helmholtz solution equation, and by using that how we calculate the molar mass of solute. Molar mass of solute, and what is the relation between Van der Helmholtz solution equation and molar mass. We'll see in continuation the derivation and problematic part. Here, the Van der Helmholtz solution equation we derive by using three principles. Already these three principles are present in states of matter. Gases obey, gases follows three gases rules. The gases are, those are Boyle's law, Charles's law and Avogadro's law. Those three laws also applicable here to dilute solutions. Why those applicable into dilute solutions? Here dilute solutions and gas are having same type of properties. That's why those gaseous laws also applied into the dilute solutions. What are those? We'll see here. Van der Helmholtz dilute solution equation. See the derivation. Here first Boyle's law is there. What is the Boyle's law? At constant temperature, the volume of the gas indirectly proportional to the pressure. That is the Boyle's law. Here the law applied into the dilute solutions. Then it becomes Van der Helmholtz law. Here, what is the Boyle's law? At constant temperature, the volume of the gas indirectly proportional to the pressure. Here, at constant temperature, the volume of the gas indirectly proportional to the osmotic pressure. Here, this may be written like this. K by pi. What is the K here? Constant. Pi is equal to constant. Yes, na? For two solutions, if any solution has, dilute solution has two solutions, one and two, what it becomes? For solution 1, pi 1, V 1. Solution 2, pi 2, V 2. Pi 1, V 1 is equal to K. Pi 2, V 2 is equal to K. Then, pi 1, V 1 is equal to pi 2, V 2. This answer is like this. Pi 1 by pi 2 is equal to V 2 by V 1. Here is the first equation. This is the Van der Helmholtz law. Second equation, Van der Helmholtz law. Van der Helmholtz law. Okay, here band of Chalisa. What is the Chalisa? The valve of the gas at constant pressure. The value of the gas directly proportional to the temperature, absolute temperature. Here also say that of charges are right as this, V is equal to KT. Okay, then V by T is equal to K. For two solutions, V1 by T1 is equal to V2 by T2. This may be written like this. V1 by V2 is equal to T1 by T2. This we call Van der Waals Chalisa. Then third one, Avogadro's law. What is the Avogadro's law for gases? At constant temperature and pressure, the value of the gas directly proportional to the number of moles of molecules. Okay, here say Van der Waals Avogadro's law. Van der Waals Avogadro's law. At constant temperature pressure, the value of the gas directly proportional to the number of molecules. Okay, here is the second equation. Okay, this is the third equation. Here V is equal to KN. V by N is equal to K. For two solutions, V1 by N1 is equal to V2 by N2. V1 by, this may be written like this, V1 by V2 is equal to N1 by N2. N1 by N2. Yes, now finish. Then see the derivations from equation 1, 2, 3. Equation 1, 2, 3. What is the equation 1? V is indirectly proportional to the first equation. Second equation, V is directly proportional to the T. Third equation, V is directly proportional to the N. See here, from these two equations, V is equal to 1 by pi. V is directly proportional to the 1 by pi, directly proportional to the T, directly proportional to the N. Yes, now? Yes. Then this may be written like this, right? Pi V is directly proportional to the T N. Remove this proportionality constant and put any constant. Okay, here I put R constant. S R R. Both N or T. R is the constant. R. One more is there. Pi V is equal to SRT. Okay, Pi V is equal to NRT or SRT. N or S, sorry, NST, sorry, not NST. S or R, or S, both are okay. We called tearing gases law, we called universal gas constant. Here we called universal dilute solution constant. Dilute solution constant. R or S is equal to 1.98 is nearly equal to 2 calories per mole per kg. Next, 8.314 joules per mole per kg. Okay, 8.314 into 10^7 x per mole per kg. Okay, x per mole per kg. Okay, these are the values of R, okay, in different units. And one more thing, here pi v is equal to nst or pi v is equal to nrt. Pi v is equal to nst or pi v is equal to nrt. You take here this equation, we call as van der Waals solution equation. Van der Waals solution equation. And here see here, from this equation pi v is equal to nrt now. Okay, pi v is equal to n by v rt. N by v, okay, number of moles by volume we call as concentration, but n by v is equal to c. So pi is equal to cst. One more principle. What is the pi? Osmotic pressure. What is the C? Concentration. What is the S? Okay, dilute solution constant. What is the T? Temperature in Kelvin. Okay, from that equation. Here, pi V is equal to nRT or nST. What is the N? N is equal to number of moles. How to calculate number of moles? Weight by molecular weight of solute. Here, weight of solute indicated with B, WB. Molecular weight of solute indicated with MB. Okay, substitute in this equation. What do you get? Pi V is equal to WB by MB RT. Cross multiply, we need MB. Why? Always will derive equation for the relation between colligative property and molecular mass. Okay, MB is equal to what? W B R T by pi. This is our relation. What is that? MB is equal to WB by WB RT by IV. What is the MB? Here MB is equal to, here I'm writing, MB is equal to molar mass of solute. WB is equal to weight of solute. Okay, R is equal to constant. T is equal to temperature. In Kelvin, definitely we take in Kelvin. Why? Because here all values are present in per Kelvin only. So you should convert into Kelvin. Next, pi is equal to osmotic pressure. V is equal to volume of solution. Okay, yes, this is about the Van der Waals solution equation and different principles. All these principles used in the calculation part. See, all are observed, all are appearing now. Visible now, all total board visible except these MB. MB is what? Molar mass. WB is weight of solute. T is temperature. In Kelvin only, pi is osmotic pressure, V is volume. What is the Van der Waals solution equation? Okay, it explains about the osmotic pressure of the solution, dilute solution. Yes, na? How it derive? It derived from three important laws. What are those? Van der Waals Boyle's law, Van der Waals Chauvelet's law, Van der Waals Avogadro's law. Okay, from these three equations, what you get? Pi V is equal to nRT or pi V is equal to nST. Okay, one more principle is there. N by V is equal to concentration. N by V is equal to concentration. So, pi is equal to CRT. Pi 5V is equal to nRT, but number of moles of solute is equal to weight of solute by molecular weight of solute, WB by MB. Why I took here B? Always solute taken as a B, solvent taken as a A. Okay, so here solute not, that's why I took MB. MB is equal to what? WRT by 5V. WB or T by 5. This is we called osmotic pressure. This is the fourth colligative property. Four colligative properties finished. We'll see some problems on this one on how to determine the osmotic pressure experimentally by using Berkeley-Hardy method, and how to determine the vapor pressure, how to determine the elevation in boiling point, how to determine the depression in freezing point in continuation. We'll see. This is also important question. Thank you.